Hi y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. Today we're gonna talk about the revolution slider. Several of our students have asked us to kind of do a quick tutorial on it. Some of our clients even use this specific slideshow environment inside of WordPress, and it's so robust. It has so many options. It's a little bit overwhelming. Sometimes you don't even really know where to start. We call that option overload. But if you take time, just kind of read through everything that you see, walk through it step by step, you're going to be able to create something super cool. Before I get started though, I want to make mention of our incredible partners and thank them, WP Engine, for their amazing secure hosting that they provide for WordPress websites. Check them out. Their support and their fast server speed is highly worth the dollar amount that you're going to be paying for your hosting package with them. They're incredible. WP Elevation, if you're an entrepreneur using WordPress, you need to check out their system. It's fantastic. And WP 101 offers you really more involved, more in-depth video tutorials, just like what I do, but they take it to the very next level. Totally worth their value of getting a lifetime membership for that website. Check those guys out and be sure to tell them that Kori Ashton sent you their way. I would appreciate that. All right, so we're going to talk about the Rev Slider. Shrink down here for a second. They call it Slider Revolution. Most people call it the Rev Slider. It's $18, so it is, you do have to pay for this, right? But it's $18, and in the big scheme of things, this is pretty stellar. Some premium themes that you might find on themeforest.net have this included inside of it. So you kind of get this value added to a premium theme if you're buying one for, let's say, $58 or $48. This would automatically come in it, and you still need to know how to use it properly. So there's a lot of cool functionality you can do. I'll put the link to this particular plugin, by the way, in the description box below, so you can get to this specific page and purchase this if you'd like to. I'm not an affiliate marketer. I don't get any money off of it. I'm gonna slide out of the way though, because what I want you to see is a live preview of what this slider, Revolution slider can do. So I'm gonna click live preview. Check this out. Look at those things just fly in. So all of that was like a little video almost. I'm going to click next over here. Slides over. Cool. Look at that zoom effect take place. Whoa. Fast, smoother, easy to use. I feel like I'm watching a movie. This is just a slideshow. Wait a second. That transition was totally different. The fade effect. Look at all these things flying in. Literally, these things are just created making layers and kind of stacking them on each other. And yet, the Revolution slider is very fast because all of this text that you see is actually text. They're not images. That's great for two things. One, loads a lot more quickly. Two, Google can still read this text that's sitting in here. That's phenomenal for SEO purposes, right? You always want to be able to read text because Google cannot read images except for the image title, of course, and the image alt tag. Another really cool thing that Rev slider can do is have video inside of it. What? Da-da-da, ba-doom-ba-da, ba-boom. What? How crazy cool is that? It totally supports video. So not only do you have this cool little fly-in, really wow factor that you can build pretty easily, but it also holds video. So you could have a video sitting right here with a big CTA button that says, check out our video. Click that and let it play. Very, very, very dynamic. Lots of possibilities. So let's get into it. What you'll have to do is actually purchase the plugin for $18. It's going to then prompt you to download the zipped file. Once you download it, let's see if I can show it to you here. Let me get to my files and open this up for a second. You would just go to your downloads and you'd be sure this is it here. You'd be sure you want to double click that and open it up, unzip it basically, because inside of it actually sits the file that you want to upload to your WordPress website. So you would go to, I'm going to slide off screen again so you can just see everything here. You would go to your plugins area. Once you've downloaded it to your computer, you would click add new up at the top, and then you would want to do an upload the plugin, right? And that's where you would upload that zipped folder just called Rev Slider. Browse, upload that, install it. Then of course you'll activate it. Once you've activated it, down on the left hand side of your screen we have this space called Revolution Slider. Let's click on that. Now your screen should look something like this. I'm creating this video in March of 2015. So if you're viewing this a few months from now or possibly a few years from now, it might look a little different, but overall the functionality should be pretty much the same. So now you want to click new, create new slider. It's going to open up. You want to give it a title, and you want to give it something pretty obvious of where you're going to be placing it or how you're going to be using it. And then the slider alias actually helps create the short code. So as soon as you start typing something in, it will create the short code. If you're familiar at all with short codes, that's how you actually would display this on a page somewhere. So if you're wanting to go build this slideshow and then go put it somewhere on any page or any post for that matter, you can do it. How cool is that? You can create as many slideshows as you want and paste them throughout your website just using this little unique short code. So you'd copy that on your clipboard and then go to the page or post that you want to display it on, paste it in there, and voila, your slideshow is going to appear in that space. Amazing. All right, slide off screen again so you can just follow my cursor down the row here. Do you want different source type? You can have posts being pulled to create a slideshow, specific post, or a gallery. We're going to keep it as a gallery because this is pretty standard of how you would create a slideshow. Do you want the layout to be auto-responsive? That's typical if you have a responsive website. And then scrolling down, all of these options can stay, and then we'll just click Create Slider. Slider was successfully created. Now it gives me back to this screen, gives me that short code again in case I need to access that again. It tells me that I have zero slides though. So let's go edit our slides. Clicking on the blue button takes you into Edit Slides. No slides found. Well, let's create something new. New slide. Right away when you click that, you're prompted to go get a picture. I've uploaded a pretty large picture that's sitting in my media library, so I'm just going to add that. There we go. Now I've got a slide. Well, I want to add some fun stuff to it, so let's edit that slide. This is the environment where all the fun happens. You can give it a unique title for this specific slide. I'm going to call it Grunge Background. You can change the status of it if you want it to be unpublished in a specific slideshow. Another incredibly powerful feature is if you want this slider to only be visible between certain dates. How cool is that? That will give you the ability to automatically have maybe an event that you're advertising be removed whenever that visible date until is reached. You can change the transition of the slide right here. You can change the duration of the slide right here. It gives you an example here. And then keep scrolling down. If you want the whole slide to be linkable, you can click Enable and it'll let you choose where you want it to go. I'm going to disable that just for now. And then scrolling down, now we begin to see what we're creating. This background source here is how I would have that big image sit here. I can change the image if I want to, or I can have a transparent background and just add layers if I wanted to. Make a solid color. Just play around with all these options and get a feel for what we're doing here. What I want you to notice though is this little outline that you've got here. We kind of want to stay within this space whenever we're adding content. It's giving you the parameters of an actual good size to stay within for most screen sizes. But what we want to do next is click Add Layer. Right away, a little area down here is going to open up and you're going to be able to edit the text. I'm going to say code is poetry. Even though this area says it, I actually want to change this and make that disappear, make my new font up here. So in order to move this picture around, I'm actually going to go back up here for a second and manipulate the background position. I'm going to change it to center. Let's do center bottom. There we go. Now it's completely gone away. And if I scroll back down, code is poetry, I get to see what it looks like here. Well, obviously that's not very visible. So how can I change this font to be purdy? And the way we do it is affecting the style here. So we'll just scroll over some of these and it'll start to show you what that text could look like. So maybe we want it to be that. Let's scroll up. Oh, look at that. That's pretty noticeable. It's kind of cool. What if I want that background to be my orange that's on WebTegrity, our specific orange? You can edit the style. This opens up and allows you to change the font family, the font color, the padding in this area that kind of extends the black color around it, and you can change the background color. I want to change that to our orange color, and that's FF90022. That's the color I want now. So I'm going to click Save Change. Now right away it's going to ask me, do you want to overwrite this class that's been listed in your database as large background, BG, black? Or do you want to save it as a new class? I want to save it as a new class and I want to name it Large Background Orange. Save as new. So now that's the way it's going to display on this screen. And I've basically created one slide that has this sitting here. Maybe I want it to slide in or fly in. I can come down here to the animation layer and now play around with different ways that it can fly in. So if I say I want it to ease in, I can set it to do that. And you're going to see an example right here of what it does. Just kind of eases in. Let's say I want it to circle in. Okay. Do something different there. Why does it look like it's all doing the same thing? I don't know. Let's get down here and see if it's doing something else. Ah, start animation. Let's do, there we go. Let's do short from right. Have it fly in that way. And this is just the specific easing back. I kind of like that. Look at that, kind of fades in right here. That's kind of cool. I want it to come from long from left. Fly in there. And basically, how long do we want it to take? Let's slow it down a little bit. Take it to 500. And that's going to be the effect now. I'm going to update my slide. And that basically creates a whole new slide with this kind of effect flying in. If I want to create another layer, you can just keep adding layers. And you come back here and change this to whatever you want it to be. Woohoo! And now that new area over here now says woohoo. You can change, just keep doing stuff. You can add a picture if you want to, add a video, all of these options. You just keep layering on different things into this one slide. Now let's say I want it to transition out and go to a totally different slide and have something new. You would just come up here to the top and say add slide. And now that's going to create a whole nother option. You'll give it a new name, new slide, and you'll go through that whole process again. And you're creating your entire slideshow. How cool is that? So let's say that you wanted this new slide to be first. How do you change the order of your slides to appear? You literally just drag and drop it. Sometimes that's not very user-friendly. You wouldn't know that right away, right? So I wanted to give you that tip in this video tutorial. I know this is a little lengthy, but there's a lot to RevSlider. If I get a lot of views on this and you guys tell me, Kori, I want to learn more, comment in the box below. I'll do another video next week, a little bit more in depth, even more so into the RevSlider. I hope you're having a great day. Catch us at your local meetup group. If you're here in San Antonio, please come by and check us out. I'll put the link in the description box below. See y'all next week. Bye-bye.